Welcome to the best time of the month. It is the time for the top 10 albums of March 2022. Time's going too fast again. Feels like just yesterday we did February, but now we're in March and we're almost in April. What's going on? But there's been so many good releases in March, like too many. This list of the top 10 has been the hardest so far this year. The amount of amazing black metal albums especially, I could make a whole top 10 black metal list, like just specifically black metal. So maybe it's a spoiler of some albums coming out onto this list. But let's have some fun. I want you guys to put down below, what's your favourite albums of March 2022? What albums surprised you? What albums did you hate? Let me know and let's get started with my number 10. Number 10 is Key to a Vanishing Future by the Falls of RAUROS. The Falls of RAUROS. I love the name. RAUROS. It's like a fucking T-Rex. A sassy T-Rex is about to eat your legs. They've been a great band, a great atmospheric black metal band for a long time. I've loved all their albums. This one is a very different one. It's a very different one. It's a lot more, I don't want to say shoegazy, but it feels more kind of like Alcest. It's more serene than a lot of the other releases. It is a very strange album in the discography, but I like the change. I like that they're doing a different direction on this release, and I think it works. Might not be my favourite one they've done, but I think it works, and it was a breath of fresh air for the band, and I think it was a great listen from start to finish, and that's why it's here on my top 10 of March. Next up, we have Spiral of Life by Sidus, Atrum. Now, I pulled a funny face when I said the name because I don't know if I've said it right. Let me know down below how to actually pronounce it. Now, this is a one woman band. You don't get a lot of them. And it's Death Doom. And it's just pure brilliance. There's a lot of growling, which is top notch. And there's a lot of singing. Well, there's some singing in it as well, but it's mainly more growls than singing. Because there are a lot of these kind of projects, usually the singing outweighs the growls, but this one is the other way around. There's more growls than singing. She does a fantastic job at both. The vocals are powerful. The music is melancholic, but also dark and heavy when it needs to be. It's great, and she's also from Ukraine, so, you know, respect. She's very talented, and this album just goes to show that. Very, very refreshing release from this year. And another one which was great, which I mentioned last year, was Convent. They got a new album out as well, which is, again, fantastic doom metal release, but it didn't quite make the cut. But this one, yes it did, and that's why it's here. Next up is We Are the Apocalypse by Dark Funeral. Now, I love this album. I did a ranking for them recently and it's, you know, mid for me. Catchy as hell song. Kind of doomy and darky. Darky? What am I talking about? Doomy and darker than usual. It's more in line with the newer kind of Dark Funeral releases. A bit more catchy, but also kind of has this Death Doom tinge to it, which I quite enjoy. Some people say it's boring, but they can go stick some potatoes in their ass. Because I don't care, I love this album. I don't think it's boring at all. It is a bit doomy, that doesn't mean boring. Some people like to put them together, but if you're one of them, fuck you. Yeah, I love every song on this album. The singles kicked ass. The album flowed really nicely as well. And it was just a fun album from start to finish. Dark Funeral, We Are the Apocalypse. It's awesome. Next up, for something completely different, we have NITE with Voices of the Kronian Moon. We'll be right back. I love NITE. The previous NITE album was in a video I did whenever it came out, like last year or the year before, and it is so good, so catchy. This is kind of like heavy metal meets black metal. Mix them together. It's like Iron Maiden meets, I don't know, Dark Funeral. Mix them together and you get NITE, and it's so good. The vocals have that black metal edge to it, but the music is pure heavy metal. The solos in it, oh my god, eye melting. Love NITE, underrated band, easily one of the best albums of the month, and such a blast to listen to. I want to re-listen to it right now. It's too fun. Gotta be here on this list. Next up for something avant-garde, Deathspell Omega with The Long Defeat. I bet you thought this was going to be like number one or something. Nope. I enjoy this one a lot. It's Deathspell. They knock it out of the park all the time. But they also have albums which, you know, they take a while to get into. Take a while to digest. And it's not quite there yet. I just need to get used to like everything on it. It just feels a bit strange coming from the furnaces of Peloponnesia to this one. Because that one's like a masterpiece. This one's very good. Not quite masterpiece just yet, but good enough to make my top 10 in the month. And I'm sure in a couple of weeks, you know, a couple of months, it'll rise higher. Maybe it'll click for me. At the moment, I think it's a very good release, and it's better than all these others that I love. Like Dark Funeral is one, I fucking love that, and I put this higher because it's Deathspell, and they don't do bad. But it's not like, oh, that has to be my favourite of the month. It's not that yet. Not yet. Maybe in a couple of months, but not quite yet. But it's still good enough to make this top 10. I don't want to slam it because I still really like the album. It's just, come on. It doesn't hold a candle to Sea, or Drought, or fucking Furnaces, or Paracletus. No. Fucking no. Bad community. But yeah, it's still a great album, and it's still going to go on this list. Uh-oh. Ghost Impera. Let's listen. Oh no, he put Ghost higher than Deathspell. That's right, Ghost was easier to digest, easier to get into, catchier songs. Love the songs in this album. This album's getting better and better the more I listen to it. Hunter's Moon is so good. It's a Hunter's Moon. The guitar, oh, Call Me Little Miss Sunshine. Yes, yes. There's a Watcher in the Sky. That song as well, oh. I still have the same problems with the last two songs, where it's kind of like, yeah, it's ballady, it's alright. But the rest of the album, oh my god, it slaps. I love it. Catchy as all hell. Say what you want, they might not even qualify for this list, but I think from the solos and the guitar and stuff, it's pretty heavy, it's pretty metal, I'd say. I'm on the line of, I think they're metal. Don't care what you think, I think they're metal. Especially Meliora. Like, this Meliora, Opus Eponymous, they're metal. Come on, say what you will about some of the others, but those albums are definitely metal. And I think it deserves a place in this list because I had fun with it and I'm going to keep going back to it because it's fucking awesome. Here we come with some of my favourites of the month, and which might end up being my end of the year because these were so hard to rank. First up, Humantone, Flourishing Fall in a Grain of Sand. This album was amazing. It had everything. It's for fans of progressive metal in the line of, say, Elder, so a bit more of a stoner tinge to it than, say, like a Dream Theater. But I think if you enjoy Dream Theater, you'll probably enjoy this as well. The solos on here, oh my god, the guitar is is brain melting. So goddamn good. Very similar to like an Elder or a Pallbearer, but more proggy. I can't get enough of this album. The singing is so ethereal as well. It kind of like, it's like a whispery, I don't know, shroud that envelops you while the guitar's going through. Great singing, great guitar. Love everything about this album. I thought it was going to be number one, but three others took the cake. And one of them was Vehemence. Not sure if I said that right, with Ordale. Definitely didn't say that right, but let's listen. This French epic fantasy-esque black metal band slash album is amazing. The other release that they did, I can't remember, a couple of years ago, I don't know if it's 2019, I'll probably get the dates wrong, correct me in the comments, but the last album was fantastic, and I was looking forward to seeing what they would do next, and this one did not disappoint. It might be even better than the previous one. I adore all these songs on here. If you're looking for some kind of like medieval black metal, for fans of, say, Summoning, Caledon Brood, that kind of style, but it's a bit more upbeat than that, it's a bit less on the symphonic flair, more on the medieval stuff, then you'll have a blast with this album. It's one of my favourites, and I thought it was going to be number one of the year again, but alas, two more to go. So number two is Deha with Decadanse. Yes. Kali. Decadanse. Oh my god, this album is fucking amazing. Two songs, 20-something minutes long each. It has everything in. It is black metal, but it has industrial flares. There's dance parts where it just starts breaking down into dance. The screams are insane, like Anal Nafrak style screams and blast beats and just like proper heaviest thing you've ever heard sections, and then it goes to some fucking dance beat, and it's just like, and you have chant sections with like Carly, oh. Has some of the, like, I mean, there's only two songs in it, but the second song on it is probably my favorite song of the year so far. In fact, if it's not my favorite by the end of the year, something's wrong, because it's probably one of the best songs I've ever fucking heard. It's even kind of funeral doomy from the first song, like the slow build-ups and everything. Oh yeah, I love it. It's got everything in. It should be number one. But there's one album I've played more than it. There's one album I've played more. But let's get to that. So my number one of the month is Izthmi. Leaving this world, leaving it all behind. From the art, I knew it was going to be my favourite of the month. Yeah, I love my arts in black metal and in metal in general, and this instantly hooked me, and I was like, this is great art. It's also great art and atmospheric black metal. Hell yes, sign me in. The screams are kind of on that kind of DSBM style, which I love. I love those kind of screams. But then there's so much beauty held within each song. It not only has like the screamy parts, but there's long sections of just beautiful moments reminding me of Aquilus, which is a band I love so much. A lot of parts remind me of that, or again, like Alcest. There's so much beauty held within this black metal album, from the art to the music itself. I adore this album. It's probably my favorite of the year so far from all the months. I keep going back to it. It's a mixture of everything. The screams are on point. The mood, it's like a cow, mood is on point, and just the atmosphere It's tasty. So yeah, it is for me. This is gonna be my favourite album of March 2022. So have you checked out any of these albums? Let me know if you have down below. What did you think of my list? And we'll see you again on another Quest for Metal.